introduction to managerial economics. That is the what is the introduction about a managerial economics. This is the first unit topic. So in introduction about managerial economics, managerial economics is an offshoot of two distinct disciplines. Management is an offshoot of two distinct disciplines, management and economics. It is with the help of two disciplines, management and economics. First of all, what is manager or what is management? So already we discussed in the last class as a management means that is a manager of the organization. So what are the responsibilities or what are the duties of managers? Are managers in their day-to-day activities always confronted with several issues? Confronted with several issues such as how much quantity is to be supplied, how much quantity is to be supplied in a market, at what price, and how much quantity is to be produced to make a given profit. That is, what quantity gives a most profit to the organization. And also, should the product be made internally or whether it should be bought from outside. This is the one of the day-to-day activity of manager is not only produce the output, that is at the same time what quantity to be produced. First of all, what quantity to be produced and what price to be fixed to a particular product. And at the same time, the product is to produce the product by his own or to purchase the product from outside for selling in the market. So these are the day-to-day activities of a manager in the organization. If you take any type of the organization, that is if it is a communication sector or if it is a production sector, that is the main activities of a manager is the main activities of a manager is that is what quantity to be produced and what price to be fixed to a product. And at the same time, that is to produce the product by his own production process or to purchase the product from outside. So these are the activities of manager. And next of all, the management is called as a science and art. It is the science and art of getting things done through people. It is the science and art of getting things done through people. Means that is what is science and what is art. So in general, the science means that is which is depending upon some cause and effects and at the same time facts. The science depends upon facts. So the manager takes the help of the science, that is for taking any important decision in the organization. For taking any important decision in the organization, that is he completely depends upon the science. And next of all, art. Art means skills. The skills are also very important to the manager. The skills are also very important to the manager for making the organization as a successful. Because we know if you take any example, that is a number of companies are, if you take a past 5 years, the number of companies are entering into the market, but only some companies are appear, remaining companies are disappear because it is depending upon the management skill. The skilled management runs the organization successful and makes the organization to move as a long run. So that is the one, that is a mainly the management contains skills. The skills of manager are helpful to the organization to move the organization as a successful. So that is called as a management is the science and art of getting things done through people by the help of his skills. That is by the help of his skills, done some work with the help of the employees. That is called as a people's. People's means employees. To make the organization as a profitable. And next of all, what are the functions and what are the responsibilities of a manager in the organization? The mainly the functions of manager in the organization is first of all planning. So planning means that is to plan before going to action. That is to plan how to implement or how to implement the activities before going to action, to plan about overall. This is also called as a rough structure of an organization. making to plan about the overall activities before going to action is called as a planning. And next function of a manager is, after planning the activities, that is to organize. To organize means that is to make some linking between different activities. So this organizing means to systematically run the overall organization by the help of the planning. By the help of the planning, that is called as a organizing. అంటే ఇక్కడ ఆర్గనైజింగ్ ఏంటంటే వన్స్ ప్లాన్ చేసుకున్న తర్వాత సో ఆ ప్లాన్ ప్రకారం ఆర్గనైజేషన్ మొత్తాన్ని ఒక సిస్టమేటిక్ గా రన్ చేయడాన్ని మనం ఇక్కడ ఆర్గనైజింగ్ అంటాం. సో ఇన్ జనరల్ ఇఫ్ యు టేక్ దట్ ఈస్ ఇఫ్ యు ఆర్గనైజ్ ఎనీ టైప్ ఆఫ్ ద ఫంక్షన్ సో ద ఆర్గనైజింగ్ మీన్స్ దట్ ఈస్ టు కూల్లీ కండక్ట్ ద ఫంక్షన్ దట్ ఈస్ కాల్డ్ యాజ్ ఎ ఆర్గనైజింగ్. నెక్స్ట్ వన్ ఈస్ డైరెక్టింగ్. సో డైరెక్టింగ్ ఫంక్షన్, ఇన్ దిస్ డైరెక్టింగ్ ఫంక్షన్ ద మేనేజర్ యాక్ట్ యాజ్ ఎ గైడ్ ఆర్ కోచ్. దట్ ఈస్ యాక్ట్ యాజ్ ఎ గైడ్ ఆర్ కోచ్. దట్ మీన్స్ హీ గివ్ డైరెక్షన్స్ టు ద ఎంప్లాయీస్. గివ్ డైరెక్షన్స్ టు ద ఎంప్లాయీస్ ఫర్ అచీవింగ్ ద ఆర్గనైజేషనల్ యాజ్ వెల్ యాజ్ ఇండివిజువల్ గోల్స్. ఇన్ దిస్ డైరెక్టింగ్ ఫంక్షన్ మేనేజర్ గివ్స్ డైరెక్షన్స్ how to achieve our goals. That means how to achieve the organizational goals with less energy, and at the same time how to achieve our individual goals, that means our personal goals. So that is called as the one of the function of a manager is directing. Next one is a controlling function. So controlling means that is to control the overall activities. After implementing the plan or after starting the action, depending upon the plan. So that is to control if any mistakes or errors are occur, that is to correct those mistakes and errors is called as a controlling. That is the one of the function of a manager. Next one is motivating. So motivating means that is to motivate the employees towards the work is called as a motivating function. To motivate the employees towards the organizational work, not with force. That is, they are take as initiating to work in the organization and to make their help, which is helpful to achieving the organizational goals. So such type of making initiation in the mind of an employee is called as a motivating. And next one is leading. So in this leading function, the manager act as a leader. In this leading function, the manager act as a leader. So that is, the leader means that is he control the overall organization as well as the employees of the organization. That is called as a leading function of a manager. So that is, these are the different functions of management are planning, organizing, directing, controlling, motivating and leading. Next, what are the responsibilities of a manager? What are the responsibilities of a manager in the organization is for achieving the targeted results to maximize the profits. For achieving the targeted results, that is for achieving the targeted results before maximizing the profit. Results to maximize the profit. This is the one of the responsibility of a manager. అంటే ఇక్కడ మనకి మేనేజర్ యొక్క రెస్పాన్సిబిలిటీ ఏంటంటే, ఏవైతే మన టార్గెట్స్ పెట్టుకున్నామో, ఒక ఆర్గనైజేషన్ స్టార్ట్ చేసేటప్పుడు ఏవైతే మనం గోల్స్ కానీ టార్గెట్ కానీ పెట్టుకున్నామో, ఆ టార్గెట్ ని మనం రీచ్ అయ్యేటట్టుగా చేస్తూ కంపెనీకి మాక్సిమం ప్రాఫిట్స్ ఇవ్వడం అనేది మేనేజర్ యొక్క వన్ ఆఫ్ ద రెస్పాన్సిబిలిటీ అన్నమాట. నెక్స్ట్, నాలెడ్జ్ ఆఫ్ ఎకనామిక్స్ ఈజ్ ఎసెన్షియల్ ఫర్ ఏ మేనేజర్ టు ఆప్టిమైజ్ కాస్ట్ అండ్ రెవెన్యూ. So these are the above all the are the functions and responsibilities of a manager. And what is the help of the economics to a manager is, that is, the economics is essential for a manager to optimize the cost and revenue, that is to produce the output with less cost and at the same time to give more profits to the organization. The economics, the knowledge of economics is helpful to the manager that is to decrease the cost of production and increase the income of the organization. So that is the management. Next, so in we already discussed about that is the managerial economics is an offshoot of two distinct disciplines. One is management and next one is economics. So we are clear about what is management. Now that is we discuss about what is economics. Next of all, we discuss about what is economics. Economics is the study of activities for spending and earning money. That is the to study the human activities which are helpful for spending the money and earning the money. That is called as a economics. Human activities means that is the each human being conducting different type of activities, such as for earning the money, some person chooses the business, the selling and purchasing business, and some person chooses as a marketing business, and some persons choose the for earning the money as a jobs. So these are the different human activities for earning the money. And there are different activities for spending the money. So spending the money means that is some persons purchase the flats or lands, that is they spend the money on different type of real estates. And some persons spend the money as a shares. So these are the different activities of human beings. That is each and every human being containing different activities for earning the money and as well as spending the money. Overall, the mainly the human activity is, it is depends upon, that is to increase his wealth. To increase his wealth, for increasing his wealth, that is he earn the money by the help of different activities as a job or business. And they spend the money for developing their monies as a to purchase the different type of bonds, post office, insurance policies, and as well as that is to spend the money on a shares. So these are the different activities. So from this, all these activities, the main purpose of the human being is that is to increase his wealth. So if you observe the Adam Smith definition about economics, Adam Smith definition about economics is a study of nature and use of national wealth. A study of nature. Economics means to study about the nature and use of national wealth. By the help of studying of nature, to use the national wealth for increasing the nature's or for increasing the resources. Next of all is the Robbins definition. Robbins definition about economics. The science which study human behavior as a relationship between ends and scarce means which have alternative use. It is the Robbins definition about economics is the science which study human behavior as a relationship between end and scarce means which have alternative use. To study about the human relationship between the relationship between ends and scarce. Ends and scarce means that is the that if you take any product in the nature, so that is any product in the nature, that is you take as it containing some recycling processes. Each and every resource in the environment or in the nature containing recycling process. So this type of alternative uses to a particular resource is called as a economics. Alternative uses of a particular resources in the nature is called as a economics. For example, if you take as a solar energy, so that is a one of the resource from the nature. By the help of this solar energy, that is the human, it is the also one of the human activity which increases income. And some type of these also, some type of other resources are also helpful to the human being for increasing his income by giving alternative uses. So that is called as a economics. So now we are clear about the economics means it studied, that is to study about the human activities for spending and earning money. But different persons explain this economics as a, with the help of different definitions. Next of all, that is the what are the types of economics. This economics are of two types. First of all, microeconomics, and second one is macroeconomics. What is microeconomics? Microeconomics means the study of individual consumer or firm is called microeconomics. The economics which study about a particular person or one particular customer or if a single firm's income, that is called as a micro. That means at micro level to study about the wealth of a single person or a firm. So in this meaning, firm means one of the branch, the organization containing, for example, 4 or 5 branches. One of the branch is called as a firm. The whole organization is called as a industry. So in microeconomics, that is to study about a particular firm or a branch economic is called as a microeconomics. Or to study about a particular person's income is called as a microeconomics. The next type of economics is macroeconomics. So the macroeconomics means the study of aggregate or total level of economic activity in country. Aggregate or total level of economic activity in country is called as a macroeconomic. That means to study about the national income, that is a national wealth or national income is called as a macroeconomics. And at the same time, whole industry, that means total economic activity, is called as a macroeconomics. That means the microeconomics tells about a individual or a particular person or a particular branch economic position, and macroeconomics tells about a whole country. And as well as that is a whole industry, economics is called as a macroeconomics. So the economics are of two types, micro as well as macroeconomics. Next, so managerial economics, the managerial economics is an offshoot of two distinct disciplines. First one, manager, and second one, economics. We know about manager and also we know about what is economic. So next of all, what is managerial economics? What is managerial economics? So managerial economics is defined by Spencer and Sisselman. Spencer and Sisselman definition about managerial economics is the integration of economic theory and business practices for the purpose of facilitating decision making and forward planning by management. Integration of economic theory and business practices for the purpose of facilitating decision making and forward planning by management, it is called as a managerial economics. So in this definition, it is clear that to apply the economical principles, that is to integrate the economical principles with business practices. What are the economical principles or economical theories? Economical theories means the theory which increase your wealth or which increase your income. That theory is called as a economic theory. Economical theory means the theory which increase your income or your wealth. That theory is called as a economical theory. And next, business practices. Business practices means that is the activities in a business which gives profits to the organization is called as a business practices. So that means in these two point of view, we are clear that economic theory's main purpose is increasing income, and business practices main purpose also to increase the income. For the main purpose of these two concepts are same. So for integrating these two theories, these economic theory and business practices, for the purpose of facilitating and taking important decisions in the organization and future planning, and at the same time future planning, that is called as the one of the definition of managerial economics, is to integrate the economical theory and business practices for the purpose of facilitating decision making and forward planning. Facilitating means that is for producing the output to make availability of all facilities such as a making availability of employees, raw material and technology. So this is the called as a making availability of all facilities for producing the output. Next one, decision making. Decision making means if any type of the problem arises in the organization, to take the decision, that is called as a decision making. And forward planning. Forward planning means a future plan about what quantity to be produced. And next of all, future planning about how much money is needed for producing in future, and what is the future of the company. So what are the changes occur in a environment? How to adopt these changes? So these are all called as a forward planning. So the managerial economics is defined as integration of economic theory and business practices for the purpose of facilitating decision making and forward planning by manager. So the manager apply these economical theories in his day-to-day business practices for making the organization as a success. Next, the Brigham and Pappas definition about managerial economics. So the Brigham and Pappas definition about managerial economics is the application of so these are the definitions about managerial economics. So that is a Spencer and Sesselman definition, and Brigham and Pappas definition is that is to apply the economical theories and methodologies in day-to-day business practices which are helpful to the manager for make the organization as a successful. Next of all is, what is the nature of managerial economics? The first nature of managerial economics is it is close to microeconomics. It is concerned with finding solution to the managerial problems of a firm. So already we know about firm means that is a single branch. If organization containing multiple branches, so one of the branches called as a firm. So microeconomics means that to deal about a particular firm is called as a microeconomics. So like that, the managerial economics is also, it is close to microeconomics. Close to microeconomics means that is the every activities, that is every decision of a managerial economics, it is closely related that to develop a single firm or to develop or to increase the income of a single branch. So that is the main nature of a managerial economics, is to increase the individual or one single person's income. Because the by increasing each and every person income in the country, so automatically total country's income increases. But the organization main purpose is that is to increase the single firm's income or to give solution to a single firm's problems. Next one is operates against the backdrop of macroeconomics. Next nature of managerial economics is it operates against the backdrop of macroeconomics. What is macroeconomics? Macroeconomics means the economics which deals about a total or whole industry or a national wealth, that is called as a macroeconomics. The macroeconomic conditions of the economy also seen as a limiting factor for the firm to operate. So managerial economics has to be aware of limits such as government policy and inflation. So in first nature, that is, it is close to microeconomics means that is managerial economics main activities are concentrated upon a single person's income, to increase a single person's income or to increase the single branch income. But the macroeconomics tells that is not only considered as a narrow, like as a micro, that is not only considered to a single form or a single person, that is the at a macro level containing, that is the at a macro levels the organization faces different type of problems such as a government policies and inflation. Government policies means that is a changing policies. Government changes its policy from time to time depending upon these, it is considered these policies. So for example, if you take any government policies, in some times the government announces subsidies to particular products. It announces some type of subsidies to a particular products. So if the organization chooses that type of the products, automatically it is beneficial. It provides subsidies. And at the same time, sometimes that is the government gives free licensing facilities for some type of exporting and importing. So if you choose that type of the exports and imports, it is beneficial to your company. So that means that is to operates against the backdrop of macroeconomics, like that type of using the government, or that is to be aware of limits of government policies and inflation, that is called as a one of the nature of managerial economics, is operates against the backdrop of macroeconomics. Next one is, that is a normative statement. Normative statement includes ought or should, good or bad, right or wrong. That type of the statements are called as a normative statements. This is right or wrong. Only just to give answer as a, is it right or wrong? To give the answer like as a, is it good or bad? There is no explanation need. That is there. There is no need of giving explanations, or there is no need of, that is the, what is the effect on future by this decision? Such type of statements are called as a normative statements. One problem with normative statement is that they cannot be verified by looking at the facts. It does not verified by looking at the facts. It only depends upon, is it right or wrong? Disagreement about such statements are usually settled by voting on them. Disagreement about such statements are usually settled by voting on them. That means that is in some situations, the manager takes the decisions by the help of voting. If most of the persons are gives vote as this decision is right, so automatically the manager implemented this decision as a right. Or if most of the votes are given that this decision is bad, that is the main, what the decision is projected the manager, that is bad. So if the votes are giving as more votes are given as it is the bad, automatically it implemented as a bad. So in this statements, there is no verification about what is fact. What is fact? Or if you take this decision, what effects are occur in future? So such type of verification does not occur in a normative statements. This is the one of the nature of a managerial economics. So in this nature, we already discussed that management is an art as well as science. But in this nature, the management is not science because it does not depends upon facts. Next one is, so in general, the normative, we choose the normative statements in some critical position. The manager depends upon normative statements in some critical position, like that there is no time. There is no time, that is to verify about the facts. And if there is a very crucial position, so that is to take the decision immediately. In these situations, that is the manager depends upon normative statements only. Next nature of managerial economics is prescriptive action. So prescriptive action means it is goal-oriented action. It is a goal-oriented action. Given a problem and objective of form, it suggests the course of action from the available alternatives for optimal solution. It is the goal-oriented action. If you use a problem and objective of form, It suggests the course of action from the available alternatives for optimal solution. That is, in this nature, the managerial economics act as a the each and every action of a managerial economics is depends upon that is the what is the goal or what is the target of the company. Depending upon these targets, that is the each and every action is implemented in the organization. That means if the manager takes the decision is its main purpose is what is our goal. For example, if the manager has an option, that is to introduce a new product in the market, so in this decision he considered, so what is our company's target or what is our company goal. If our company goal is to increase the sales or to gain the profits, in these situations, that is the manager takes the action, course of action, which are related to our goal. So he introduces a new product in the market, automatically the sales increases. So that is he takes this type of the decision because our company goal is to increase the sales. So that means in these situations, each and every activity of the manager is, that is, it concentrated only upon the goals or targets of a company. So that is the one of the nature of managerial economics is prescriptive action. This prescriptive action. Next of all is applied in nature. Next nature of a managerial economics is applied in nature. The models are built to reflect the real life situations. These models are immense help to managers for decision making. It is the applied in nature means that is in managerial economics. That is, it does not only the decisions of a managers are not in imaginations. Not in the imagination, they are applied in a nature with the help of some models. With the help of some models, they are applied in a nature, and depending upon the results, that is, they take the decision. Depending upon the results, they take the decision. So that is called as a building the models. Building the models means that is, for example, that is, if the company wants to purchase a new machine for producing the output, so in these situations, so it does not depends upon only imagination, that is, a new machine gives more quantity of production and it gives more profits. So in these situations, that is, it to try, that is, to build a small model which operates likely as a new machine. So by the help of this model, that is, to analyze about what are the problems arise by the help of a new machine and what are the benefits with the help of a new machine with the help of a simple model. So like that, that is the managerial economics is applied in nature. అంటే ఇక్కడ మనం మోడల్స్ బిల్డ్ అంటే మనం ఏం చెప్పుకోవచ్చు అంటే మేనేజరల్ ఎకనామిక్స్ యొక్క డెసిషన్స్ ఎలా ఉంటాయి అంటే సపోజ్ ఏదైనా ఒక డెసిషన్ తీసుకునేటప్పుడు జస్ట్ ఇమాజినేషన్ చేసేసి తీసుకుంటే బాగుండిద్ది అని అన్నట్టుగా కాకుండా ప్రతి దాన్ని ఒకసారి నేచర్ లో అప్లై చేసిద్ది అనమాట. అంటే ఫర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ మనకు ఒక కొత్త ఏరియా కనిపించింది, అక్కడ మన ప్రొడక్ట్ కి సేల్స్ బాగా ఇంక్రీజ్ అయ్యిద్ది అని చెప్పి మన హడావుడిగా ప్రొడక్షన్ చేసేసి ఆ ఏరియాకి పంపించేసి మార్కెటింగ్ తర్వాత జరిగిందా లేదా అని అలా చూసుకోవడం ఉండదు అనమాట. అంటే ఇక్కడ ఏం చేసింది అంటే సింపుల్ గా కొన్ని శాంపిల్ ప్యాకెట్స్ ని అక్కడ డిస్ట్రిబ్యూట్ చేయడం, శాంపిల్ ప్యాకెట్స్ ఏవైతే ఉంటాయో అక్కడ డిస్ట్రిబ్యూట్ చేసి వన్స్ అవి బాగా సేల్స్ అయితే రిజల్ట్ బాగున్నాయి అనుకోండి అప్పుడే ప్రొడక్షన్ స్టార్ట్ చేసి అది అనుకున్న క్వాంటిటీని ప్రొడక్షన్ చేసిద్ది అనమాట. అంటే ఇక్కడ ఏంటి, ప్రతి దాన్ని ఒక మోడల్ గా బిల్డ్ చేసి దాన్ని అక్కడ రియల్ లైఫ్ సిచ్యువేషన్ లో అప్లై చేసి దాని రిజల్ట్ ని బట్టి డెసిషన్స్ తీసుకోవడం అనమాట. సో మనం జనరల్ చూస్తూ ఉంటాం కొన్ని మనకి ఏంటి ఎయిర్ పొల్యూషన్ ఇలాంటి పొల్యూషన్స్ కి చిన్న చిన్న మోడల్స్ బిల్డ్ చేస్తూ ఉంటారు పిల్లలు ప్రాజెక్ట్ అని చెప్పి. సో అలాంటి మోడల్స్ అనమాట అలా బిల్డ్ చేసి సపోజ్ దాన్ని బట్టి మనం ఇమాజినేషన్ వేయకుండా డెసిషన్ తీసుకోవడం అనమాట. అలాగే సపోజ్ ఏదైనా ఒక కొత్త సపోజ్ ఎక్కువ మంది ఎంప్లాయీస్ ని ఆర్గనైజేషన్ తీసుకోవాలి అంటే రిక్రూట్ చేసుకోవాలి అనుకుందనుకోండి, మన కంపెనీకి అంత స్పేస్ సరిపోయిద్దా లేదా అని చెప్పింది. అక్కడ ఏం చేసింది అంటే చిన్న చిన్న ఎంప్లాయీస్ ఎంతమంది నించోడానికి స్పేస్ సరిపోయింది అన్నట్టుగా ఒక మోడల్ ని బిల్డ్ చేసుకునేది అనమాట. సో బిల్డ్ చేసి సో ఈ స్పేస్ చేస్తే మనం ఇంతమంది ఎంప్లాయీస్ అయితే ఆ మిషన్ దగ్గర వర్క్ చేయడానికి ఈజీగా అవుతారు అని అనుకున్నప్పుడే దాన్ని డెసిషన్ గా ఇంప్లిమెంట్ చేయడం అనమాట. సో దట్ ఈస్ కాల్డ్ యాజ్ ఎ అప్లైడ్ ఇన్ నేచర్.